Views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh, glory, glory, glory.
Hands to the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtapositioning us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walked through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground. The camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up.
Good morning. Welcome to Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. You know this voice already. It's Leyvon Miller. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for letting me join you. I don't know what it is you do at 11 o'clock, but whatever it is you do, I'm happy that you're doing that do and that you have decided to do that do with me. Let me just let you all know that I am very well aware of what's happening in the news. No, I haven't forgotten that news exists. But, you know, I kind of still in this, you know, in the season of giving. And so until International PLP Day, or maybe even after. So for the whole month of January, I still giving away free things. And not just like regular free things, like free things so that you don't be fat and bad looking, right? And so yesterday I had Shaking with me. And, you know, for the people that are saying, oh my God, it's so insensitive to say that people are fat. You're either fat or skinny or medium size. That's kind of just the way it is, right? Like me, I'm a fat guy, and I work on that every day. And so I want to help you to not be a fat guy because, you know, I mean, come on, who wants to be fat, right? So, since it is January and you all already did all of that stuff, you know, the stuff that you do, the ham and the turkey and the macaroni and the brown rice, and which is really white rice cooked down in tomato paste and fried onions and sweet peppers and that and oil, and Western oil, actually, that you turn brown with kitchen bouquet and that kind of stuff, right? You know the kind of stuff that you do, and you eat the fried plantains, and you have the lobster salad, and what else do you add to this thing? And then you know, behemoths are the funniest thing. They eat every single starch that they can find, and then say the devil got my pressure up. No, the macaroni have your pressure up. That's what's going on with you. But I am very well aware of what's happening. I just want to say to the Prime Minister, Mr. Davis, please don't listen to Michael Pintard. Don't listen to nothing this boy have to say. Don't mind him, but no locking down. If Michael wants to lock something down, tell him go where he live and lock the door there. Don't fool with this locking down thing. We ain't playing with that. Let me tell you now, if you want to survive, don't fool with locking down. Now, let me also say that, you know, yesterday I had the opportunity to register to a local institution here in the Bahamas. And much to my chagrin, almost all, if not all of their goings on is still happening on virtual platforms, right? And I will tell you what disappointment and dismay I have in the world, particularly with people in leadership right here in the Bahamas. Y'all still making $90,000 and $100,000 and $120,000 and $180,000 a year salaries, right? To operate at about 30% of the capacity that y'all were operating at, because none of y'all operations are face-to-face or in-person these days, and everything is virtual and on a computer, and I have to use all of my resources and my electricity and my data and my every Jesus thing else, and yeah, and my time, right, to be able to facilitate something that I'm paying you $100,000 to make available to me, You still want the $100,000, but you have not yet. No one yet has come up with a system. I mean, you know, separate and apart from, who knows, maybe Lisa McCartney, nobody else, has come up with a system where you say, man, that is amazing what they've been able to do down there at that place. The person that is collecting the $100,000, in my estimation, is only being paid to manage a system that they met in place. No one in this new world, and if I'm wrong, please, 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 please call me and let me know. No one that I've witnessed at any institution or any organization or has gone to, whether it is, do you know that banks in the Bahamas are still requiring 2 years later for people to stand outside in the elements? Like, that is still the plan. We haven't figured out a roster system. We haven't figured out any kind of system, a call-up system. The only thing we've done for the years is make it more difficult to be a patron. And I can't figure that out. It doesn't make sense to me. Nor have we taken into consideration the people that have aversions to the social media platforms. Like, Leyvon Miller never cares to do anything virtually. I apologize. That's why I come in the studio every day, brave the elements, and possibly risk COVID. Because I would prefer to physically be here, because this is physically where I am paid to be. And that's just kind of how I am. Maybe I'm an anomaly. Who knows? But all I know is that it is just curiously interesting that people have very many big titles. This is completely off the topic, but this is in my head. People have so many big titles, so many salaries, all sorts of emoluments, accoutrements, and attachments to these offices, right? They got the big brass plaque on the door, president of. And this Mr. or Madam President, you ain't fixed one thing in 2 years. Nothing at all. You still collect, we ain't giving you a virtual $90,000. You and the $90,000 are quite face-to-face. Yet, it shows, you know, and it shows. My good friend Jeffrey Lord, I saw him. I didn't even watch it. I couldn't make myself listen to Jeff. I tried. The little green man on my shoulder said, listen, cut this off for you, cuss. I say, you know something, little green man? You right. And so I cut it off. But it proved to us that in the absence of tangible, face-to-face, everyday showing up to work, many of you will do no work. That is why so many of these schools are in a complete state of rut. I don't know what Jeffrey Lloyd is talking about, right? Just drive past Carmichael Primary. Just drive past it. Just drive past Anatole Rogers. Just drive. It is Blind Blake and Batamares in a helicopter could see that those two schools would not have been prepared for students to attend should face-to-face have been allowed. I mean, you know, don't fondle my feelings in that fashion. That's what I always ask people to do, all right? And so while we working in this, I don't even know what this is about, but while we working through the new world, right, y'all with these six figures and very high figures, five-figure salaries, let us see if we could create some systems, create some things, have some ideas. My God, all of the things that remain and exist around here can't be the things that remained and exist when Christopher Columbus landed, man. We must have been able to come up with something. We can't still be using the formula of 78. That can't be what it is that we are measuring or marking the manner of our bearing by. We are living in a post-pandemic world. And for all intents and purposes, listen to me, COVID, COVID-19 got more variants than Jamaican women got cousins, all right? Let me make that abundantly clear. We are never getting past this. All that money we keep paying you, it is time for something more than autopilot management. You've got to figure it out, figure out how we're going to mitigate damage, and then figure out what is our response going to be when we actually come face to face with the thing. How are we going to deal with the people that are opposed, and rightfully so, to being vaccinated? At this point, I at least wish I had waited until the vaccination lottery, because I go and get vaccinated for free. Y'all come out here at Christmas and give it out $500. I dared bad, and I feel like the Fox Foundation will be $250 at least, right? Because I not only did I go and get vaccinated, I encourage all kind of people to go. I feel like that was worth $250. The point I make is we live in a new world with a new, unfound, unforeseeable pandemic on our hands that is possibly going to linger with us for 5 more years. Michael Pintard, locking the door is not the answer. You will have wonderful growing grass in a yard full of dead cows if you take that approach. And so that's what I want to say about that. Also, I have some random thought in my head. Do you ever notice how it is interesting that they call people from New Providence Nassuvians, but we don't call people Georgetownians, right? If Nassau is the capital
Why do we refer to people, why do we not call them New Providencians or New Providence Islanders, right? Because we don't call people from Freeport, Freeportians. We call them Grand Bahamians, do we not? And that is kind of how we refer to them, right? So interesting when you think about these things. That's random fodder that's going on in my mind, that's going on in my mind on the way here. Anyway, that's not what we're talking about this morning. What I am talking about this morning, because I don't want you to be a fat boy, all right? I want that belt to actually fit. No, I don't want you to have to request the attachment when you go on the airplane. And don't act like you're comfortable with requesting the attachment. No one is comfortable with needing the extension. So let me help you, right? You go see Shea King, you get on the 21-day cleanse, right? You do that. That should take you down 21 pounds in 21 days. I telling you, I swear by it, it works. This thing heals the sick and raises the dead, I promise you, right? But once you're done with that, I have in studio with me, because we're giving away more free tanks, right? So let me give you all the numbers early. You want to pay attention to this show, right? I'm not talking about anything other than fitness today. So the numbers are 323-6232-325-4316 or 325-4259. I'm going to say that again for you. My numbers here, 323-6232-325-4316 and 325-4259. You can call me in any one of those numbers. You can text me if you want to be a part of the show, 422-4796. I'm in studio with Mr. Antonio Miller. He is the president of Raw Fitness. And believe it or not, his story is kind of interesting. Like, Raw Fitness was actually born out of the pandemic, right? And, you know, he got plenty of muscles, right? I believe Jesus gave him some of these muscles. I'm sure Waking will give him all of these, right? Because these fellas, they like Chuck Norris. You ever see Chuck Norris on the Bowflex commercial? So Chuck Norris comes on the Bowflex commercial and says, man, Bowflex is amazing. Yes, Chuck. And those other muscles came from the 35 years of kickboxing. And that had nothing to do with Bowflex. But Antonio Miller is here with me this morning. He's the president and CEO of Raw Fitness. And we're talking about his journey through becoming a business owner, getting into fitness, starting the whole fitness platform, and then be giving away, what is it, 3-1-1? What are we giving away?
We're giving away 3 1-week access to the gym.
3 1-week access to his gym, which is located where?
Right off Williams Drive, off St. Vincent Road.
All right. Now, Bahamians ain't good with street names, so don't fool with that. Do you know where, what the Andy Garr School is?
Andy Garr Preschool.
All right. So if you know where Andy Garr Preschool is, because you could Google that, Andy Garr Preschool. Once you find Andy Garr, you head, that would be north. Or toward downtown. That's the people that say. So when you know, once you know, so you get onto Cowpen Road, which is where Prince William is. So Prince William, you come by Prince William, you turn right. So you'll be heading towards the airport. You drive down, that'll be the 1, 2, 3, 4th corner on the right-hand side. You turn through there, it's a hill. There's a school by the name of Andy Garr. It's the same preschool that Jerome Fitzgerald get in all kind of trouble for renting on behalf of the Bahamas government. You can go check it in the newspaper. Once you pass that, you go north, like you're heading towards downtown. And I think it's the 3rd building on the right-hand side. Is that the 3rd or the 4th?
Well, it's about the 4th one, the blue and blue triplex, right, on the left. It's right in the yard. It's a big open area.
Yeah.
And the gym
you
is right
miss
there.
It. The gym is in
you
plain
can,
view.
You really can't miss it.
Yeah. Okay. So, Antonio, tell me a little bit. You know, you were a guy in the hotel business. That's just kind of what you did full-time. But always very much into using your hands, always very much into fitness and maintaining your physical posture, et cetera, et cetera. How did the idea of Raw Fit come about? And you know, what exactly were you trying to obtain when you started the program?
Well, like most people, when COVID came, it was more time, a lot more time on my hand than I really had bargained for.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, you've tried to keep active because one of the things you don't want to do is not keep moving. We all know the story that an object in motion stays in motion,
mm-hmm,
and an object at rest stays at rest. So with all that time on my hand, I have had a couple of dumbbells, but I wanted to expand the outside gym so that I feel as if I'm not missing anything from Mac 360.
Mm-hmm.
All right? And yeah, so
which is who you basically tried to compare yourself parallel to when you were, you know, creating
pretty,
your own.
Pretty much. Yes. And so out of that, I figured, okay, let's get this gym together. And let's start buying some equipment and let's start putting some things in place so I don't feel like I've left anything. And it's amazing. Even during the pandemic, I'll go to the shop and people will be like, well, how is it that you still look good? You know, what are you doing during the pandemic? And working out, you know, and that blossomed. I put up some videos and lo and behold, I found that there are like-minded people like myself in the area who wanted to get in some shape pretty much who wanted to come out of the pandemic mm-hmm. better mm-hmm. than how they went into it.
Okay.
We just didn't know the pandemic was going to last this long.
Right.
So what has been the growth like? What has the growth been like with regards to, you know, starting a new business in the pandemic or starting a new venture in the pandemic? Because it didn't really start off as a business. You actually...
No, it started off as a personal thing. Yes.
Right. As a personal thing that yes. turned into like friends and family recreation thing. Yes. And it's now turning into something that is actually a business that you yes. are venturing toward. And yes. you have people that actually are signing up and that are seeing the results.
Yeah.
But when you watched it evolve into that, you know, at what point did you realize that, wow, raw fitness is actually taking shape?
It actually kind of like dawned on me when I realized that I'm having group classes. I had group as much as 8 to 10 persons, you know, and they're excited to get in shape. Like I said, I think had a lot of time on their hand and just wanted to get out of the house kind of thing. And I realized after looking at a few other gyms, because again, I went around the neighborhood and saw one or two persons that were doing similar things, but it wasn't set up the way mine were. And I figured, you know what? I have a good thing going here. And I got some good feedback and people like it and it blossomed into that. That's when I realized that it makes sense. Mm-hmm. It makes total sense to be able to offer this service to not just myself or friends, but anyone who want to get in shape and want to look different and want to prolong their life, those kind of things, mm-hmm. you know?
Mm-hmm. Now, I see you say here that you offer personal training, group training, cardio workouts, fitness programs, weight training, self-workouts, and you said that the space is limited, which is cool because that reduces the fear of people who mm-hmm. are not very interested in working out in big gyms, right? Mm-hmm. Like I tell people all the time, I won't do well in a big gym. Mm-hmm. I'm like a firefly. I'm easy mm-hmm. to distract, mm-hmm. right? And so most times I go into a gym, I don't do fancy gyms very well. Like mm-hmm. I like grit and iron and mm-hmm. rust. And
you get distracted with all the fancy
all over the place. I can't take it.
Flashing like
right. I need to go into a gym that just looks like a gym to me. It's compact and I know I want to do arms today. I want to do chest today. I want to do back today. I want to do abs today, which abs is every day. And so your small compact gym, I guess, is tailored to people who would say like, well, I'm not interested in going around 150 people in a gym because of COVID or mm-hmm. because of what COVID has now changed the world into. Tell me about how that personalized experience actually offers benefits to people like myself.
Well, a lot of people now, Mr. Miller, can be intimidated with the gym. You know, when I say intimidated, you know, they go into the gym and they see a lot of people in the gym that are fit, mm-hmm. you know, and the machines can be a little bit cumbersome,
right?
You know, not knowing how to keep right form, not knowing. Many times I'm in a gym, person come and like, okay, how do I use this? Mm-hmm. What's the best form to keep mm-hmm. with this? What's good about personalized training is that one-on-one or even up to 4 or 6 persons, that's still kind of personalized, you mm-hmm. know what I mean? Mm-hmm. That allows the trainer to keep an eye on you and to make sure you keep your form, which mitigates injury. So mm-hmm. you want to make sure that the people who come to the gym leave and they feel muscle soreness, not any kind of
injury.
You know mm-hmm. what I mean? But yes, the personalized service, and that also builds their confidence because not only do you feel confident when you know how to use a machine or your form is right, you feel confident knowing that you're just doing it right, mm-hmm. you know, and you get the best result of
right,
it.
Right.
You know? So I tell anybody, you need nothing like personalized training mm-hmm. because whereas you can slack up on your own, mm-hmm. many times people go to the gym, they're on their phone for 30 minutes. Yeah. Now, you've been to the gym for an hour.
Those are my favorite.
They're on the phone. Doing Facebook and WhatsApp for like 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And then every time they catch themselves, like they're in the gym, they'll extend their legs.
Six reps, beach body. The one thing I like, women are my favorite, right? Because, you know, nobody has more workout paraphernalia than women, right? Like, they have the whole set.
The whole Armagilia, yes.
Everything. You know, brand new Reeboks. Yes. And if you're working on Reeboks, you ain't serious, right? Yes, sorry, Nike, right? And so they come out with all the gab on and, you know, they do like 2 curls, 1 curl, 2 curl, and then
check Facebook.
Beach body, getting the hashtag. Selfie. Yeah, hashtag beach ready, hashtag beach bum all summer. You know, they do 1 chest press, maybe 1 pec curl, and all of a sudden they just got to, you know, now they have a video, a 2-minute video of them wiping it. And I say to them all the time, if you're doing all this snapping, when are you doing the working out? You know, even if you have someone recording it for you, I imagine they're not doing any workout because there's really no way to do all of this videoing and work out effectively if you're going to work out effectively.
No, there isn't. I totally agree. And I always tell people, you know, you can get a solid, good workout mm-hmm. in 30 minutes.
30 minutes, yeah.
And I'm talking about your rest periods, maybe even 30-second rest periods. Mm-hmm. You can get a solid workout in 30 minutes, mm-hmm. whether that's a cardio day or that's a strength training day. Mm-hmm. You know, and I'm talking about where you feel as if, wow, I felt like
I put in work.
2 hours.
Yeah, I put in work. Yeah.
And that's one of the biggest thing, one of the biggest pet peeves that I have is, you know, they always say, well, you don't rest much. You don't really pay me to rest.
Right.
You know, you can sleep.
Right. You could rest when you go home.
You can rest when you go home. Mm-hmm. If you give me a solid hour, for example, my personal training, you give me a solid hour. And my plan is to get the maximum amount of potential I can in that very short period.
Yeah,
you can have a water break. It mean much. You take a water break, you walk, take the water, you come back.
Right.
You don't catwalk to take a water break.
Yeah, yeah. Saunter.
You know, do a couple of shots.
Yeah.
Go check your WhatsApp or your email.
Yeah, yeah.
Sip some water and then come. No. I tell people all the time, when your heart rate is up and you're ready in that, not really a caloric deficit, but when you're ready in the point where your heart rate is
your burn zone,
elevated,
yeah.
You know what I mean? You want to keep it there.
Right.
You know, you want to keep it there as much as possible.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Unless you're fat like me and it's get shortness of breath. Like sometimes I push my body to the point where I feel like, listen to me, if I don't stop, my body will stop itself.
Let me tell you all something. Mr. Miller lives no more than about 10 minutes away from me.
Mm-hmm.
So he ain't gonna tell you all this, but no more than 10 minutes away from me. All right. And he knows exactly where my house is.
Yeah.
All right. And he knows that there's no issue with him coming by and us doing a couple of sessions.
Yeah, yeah. But except for the fact that I'm fat.
I think to avoid all of that, I think he takes an alternate route. I just think he just doesn't want to pass my place.
I'm fat and I'm lazy and I'm old. And if you see me running, I want you to call the police because I was mugged and someone stole my car at gunpoint. Yeah. Let me read a text message here. This one says, great show as usual. Tell your guests I would love to go to the gym, but there is always an overachiever in the gym lifting 4 barbells while doing jumping jacks on 1 foot. How do I go to the gym and avoid you? And that is a real thing, right? Because I can tell you, sometimes you get in a gym. Let's just say you get in small gyms or gyms that are not the massive mega gyms, right? So the machines are limited, right? And so you can't spot with this guy because he's lifting every piece of metal in the gym. The only thing in here he ain't lifting up is the fridge, right? Overachieving self. And so you don't want to ever find yourself in the way of that person, because trying to rack and unrack and rack and unrack is just going to be tedious and you know, necessary.
First and foremost, I would dare to say that if anyone in that place needed gym more than him, or between the two of you, it'll be you.
Right.
The result of him working or lifting for so long is why he can rack 6 and 7 plates.
Right.
Put on 6 and 7 plates.
Right, but there are people that are intimidated by that kind of stuff, right? There are people that don't know what to do. They don't know. A lot of people don't even know routines. Like, people that go to the gym all the time figures, oh, it's just a basic routine. No, there are some people that if you put them in the gym, they will not know step one. They don't know how to warm up. They don't know how to stretch. They don't know what are their out of the gate reps, you know what I mean? Lower weight reps with higher number of repetitions, yes.
Lower sets, higher
to get
reps.
You warm up, et cetera, et cetera. They don't know these things, mm-hmm. right? So a lot of people are intimidated to actually walk in a gym and say, well, okay, I'm in the gym now, and
what do I do?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
How is it different at Raw?
Well, first and foremost, with personal training, your first month, it's really conditioning mm-hmm. to find out exactly where your level is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where your level at. No one ever comes into the gym at the same level.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And like I mentioned earlier, the big gyms could be really intimidating.
Mm-hmm.
But when you come in, and let's say, for example, there's a number of different programs I have at Raw. You have where I have persons who just get gym membership.
Mm-hmm.
And those persons with gym membership, primarily they know exactly how to work out. You know, they know the basics.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I always tell them, come with your goal in mind. In other words, if you come there to work out back or shoulders mm-hmm. or chest or leg, don't deviate from that. Because I think your clearest thought was before you get to the gym.
Right.
And when you get to the gym, other things may right. come in and, you know, interfere with that thought.
Yeah, yeah.
But yes, if you come to work out back, then know that I come to work out back
mm-hmm.
and do the back exercises that will give you the results you want.
Right.
Don't start to work out back and then go to curls because you feel like I want to do curls.
Mm-hmm.
Because now I think you're losing the objective of that day.
Right.
Because curls can be tomorrow.
Right.
You know what I mean? Or the day after.
Right.
But to kill the intimidation that most people feel, yes, Raw does not have that, because first and foremost, we don't have 6, 7, 8 plates in the first place.
Right.
We have sufficient plate for everyone that is anywhere from beginning level to most likely advanced, but not so much that, you know what I mean? But yes, we hold your hand, we walk you through it. Okay. So there's no need. I have trained persons to go to big gyms, meaning that I've always said this. I said, when you leave Raw Fit and you feel after your 6 months, whatever have you, because working out is a lifestyle.
Right. You have your whole life to do it.
Yes, this isn't something you just do because you want to either get into that dress, you want to eat more for the holidays, so you try to burn some of the...
You're not going to get to talk my business on air.
You're trying to pre-burn calories. Right. If I burn... If I burn 1,000 calories now, I can eat 1,000 calories later, right?
That's exactly how I do the math.
It don't work that way, okay? Yeah. So working out is a lifestyle. You have to be comfortable knowing that, okay, I need to get in about 30 to 40 minutes three times a week. Mm. 30 to 40 minutes three times a week. Whether even if you do some solid state cardio, which is some brisk walking could be done. Mm-hmm. Brisk walking. I'm not talking about the
gossip walk the girls on the highway just do. If you could gossip about Sheila and her husband, y'all ain't exercising.
Okay. I ain't gonna hit that.
They're my favorite to watch. As a matter of fact, sometimes I drive down the Charles Sanders Highway, right? And I drive slow just to see if I could hear the gossip. Yeah, girl. And she said she's been to the mall. I said, what mall? And I said to myself, well, if y'all could talk clear like that, I don't think y'all heart rate is elevated at all.
Brisk walking. So you need to pick up the pace a bit, okay? Mm-hmm. Where if you talking with somebody, here's the thing. If you on a phone... If you're on the phone and the person listening to you can't tell that you're doing some type of exercise...
Chances are you're wasting time.
I'm just saying, pick up the pace. Sound like you're exerting yourself. You know what I mean? It sound like you're tired.
Right.
You know, don't sound like you can hold your breath and walk.
Yeah.
No.
If you know exactly where all the commas are in your sentence and you're exercising, you're not exercising.
Yeah. So some brisk walking, but it is a lifestyle. Mm-hmm. So like I said earlier, I tend to train people to you know, if you decide to go to another gym after Raw, whether the big gyms, you're not intimidated anymore because when you go there, you feel comfortable. You know your form
is
right.
You know what it is you want to do. You know how you need to get there. You know what you need to use. Yes. You know which machines you need to use. Okay. Now, is there any meal lifestyle change associated with Raw? Or is Raw... Because, I mean, you know, you may be like me. Like, I'm one of those guys. I eat whatever the hell I want. This is what I tell people all the time. One can of soda is equal to 2 miles on the road. It's that simple.
So you prefer to drink a can of soda and walk 2 miles, right?
Yeah, one can of soda is about... Let me use beer, because I know the formula. One beer is equivalent to 2 miles on the road. One beer is 260 calories.
Uh-huh.
You need to run for about 20 minutes to burn 260 calories. So one beer is equivalent to 2 miles on the road. And if you're comfortable with that, then have a case.
But you just break even, though.
Just have a case. But for some people, that's all it is. Like, for some people, like, I'm not ever going to go and compete for Mr. Olympia, right? That's never going
to
happen.
And that's another important thing, by the way. When you start your workout routine or your workout regime, you want to make sure you have the end in mind.
Right.
And I said it because I tell a lot of my, you know, the persons I work with and a lot of my clients, I said, listen, my goal is really a jeans and t-shirt kind of goal.
Right.
You know, and they say, what that means? I'm like, listen, I want to look good in some jeans and t-shirt.
I want to look strong enough not to be played with.
Well, that too. I want to enter, here's the thing, I want to enter the room. I know she said this on air, right?
Yeah.
But I want to enter the room and I want, you know, when the fella come in there and he scans.
Right, he starts sizing people up. Yeah, I'm not in his first category of people. That's what I go for.
Yeah, pretty much. I want to be out of the realm of him even thinking about.
Correct. Like I want him to say, that's not the guy I want to go fist the cuff with in a bar fight.
Pretty much.
This is what I go for most.
So start with the end in mind. And a lot of people too, like I said, it's a lifestyle. They start with, okay, I want to get in shape for this wedding or this party I'm going to go to or the summer bash the work is having or whatever have you. And I want to just look good for that.
Mm-hmm.
And if that's your starting goal, then that's fine. Let's get started. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But you have to start with the end in mind because you have to remember, one of the first things I think always happen. That's why our New Year's resolutions are forgotten by February?
Mm-hmm.
March? Okay, let's say March.
Mm-hmm.
It's because we forget why we started in the first place. You have to remember why you started.
And most people start from a place of regret. Like, you don't start because you want to start. You start because you feel bad about what you've already done. So you feel bad about the fact that you one ate the whole family ham, right? Like, there's no more ham and you, the cupcakes, you're the one that ate it all. So you feel bad about that. You go tell your girlfriend's, girl, I eat the whole ham. I don't know what I was. It tastes so, my mama put the sugar on it. It tastes so good. Now you need to go see Raw Fit, okay? That's what needs
to happen. Pretty much.
You look funny. We don't know exactly how this clothes fit on you no more. And we want you to fix it, all right? We got to go to a break. 323-623-2325-4316-325-4259. I've got 3 1-week free gym access that you could have. We got some questions for you on the next side of the break. I'm Leyvon Miller. It's Guardian Radio. Don't move. I've got more show going on.
Boy, why you look so mashed up, like clothes at the washer?
No, boy, just a hard day, boy.
Hard day? What happened? The breakfast lady ran out of tuna and gritsy.
We need to start joking about everything, you know. This serious, boy. This real serious, boy.
Boy, what's serious? Tell me.
All right, well, today, boss gave us boy one big contract. And nobody else get a chance and nobody say nothing.
Boy, you know that ain't right. You know government contracts ain't supposed to go that way.
Yeah, but nobody's saying nothing. Boss man just tell people to sign the papers. Then he sent me to meet his boy downtown and collect this envelope.
You need to tell somebody. You need to become a whistleblower.
You know I's a real man, but I never blow no whistle. I be drunk all my life in Junkano.
No way. A whistleblower is someone who tells people what they see when they see something wrong happening at work.
But I ain't no whistleblower, and I ain't no snitch. I still wait there, you know.
But ain't nobody gonna know it's you. All you gotta do is call Crime Stoppers, or you could text them from inside the Crack Crime Bahamas app. They don't ask about you. And your call goes straight through to Miami, so nobody know you is. And if you text, your message get mixed up like Kong Salad.
Call 328-8477 from Nassau, or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands.
Hey, did you find the show interesting? Do you want to be a part of the conversation? Well, sponsor Unleashed today. Call 302-2304 or 302-2375 to see which package is right for you. Join Leyvon Miller as he ignites the passion of the next generation by bridging the gap with engaging conversations and innovative ideas. Take action and sponsor Unleashed today at 302-2304 or 302-2375 and be unleashed.
Do you know you can get your business cards designed and printed for as low as 18 cents a card? If it's a poster you want, you can pay as little as $6 a square foot. If your print needs are short or long run, digital printing, wide format, or print consultation, call the best. Call Printmasters. Printmasters' goal is to provide its clients with the highest level of personal, professional service at an affordable price. Our state-of-the-art technology also makes working together efficient and easy. Laminations, business cards, flyers, posters, window and floor decals are just a few of the digitized print services offered at Printmasters. Call 302-2361, 302-2361, or visit us at the Nassau Guardian Building in Oaksfield. Print with the best. Print with Printmasters.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for staying with me. Leyvon Miller here. That means I'm unleashed on your radio. That means it's somewhere between 11 and 12 o'clock. I've got some things I want to give away. Let me give you the phone numbers. Y'all like to say that I say them too fast. I'm working assiduously on saying them slowly for you all right? 323-6232-325-4316-325-4259. You can call me in any one of those, all right? The first question I've got to ask, I said that this gym was in the general area of a preschool. If you can give me the name of the preschool that I called, let me make it a little more difficult than that. Give me the name of the preschool and what direction you got to be heading in order to run into the gym. I have a free 1 week gym access for you. The numbers, 323-6232-325-4316 or 325-4259. You can call me on any one of those numbers. Text writer here says, Mr. Miller, please play the soundbite where Mr. Pindad requested. I know what the soundbite says. The soundbite says he thinks that it's reckless to take it off of the table. At some point, we may need to go back to it. And so to suggest that it is completely off the table is reckless. I know what the soundbite says. What exactly about what I say do you think should change? I don't care. Unless fire fall from heaven, don't lock me back in a house. That's all I'm trying to say to you, all right? Let's take this phone call. Good morning, Carly. You're on. Carly, there?
Hello.
Hi.
Yes, coming down to the trivia question.
Mm-hmm.
Is Andy Gar?
Mm-hmm.
You said head in northern direction.
No, and north means what way?
Head to what Bay Street.
All right, good. That, hold the line, my producer. Will take your number and your name. And we will get back to you with your 1 week membership, all right?
Thank you.
All right. Appreciate it. 323-623-2354-316-325-4259. You can call me on those numbers. The next question, this one should be pretty easy. What is the name of the gym and when was it started? Or how was it started? When was it started? I gave a specific time as to when the gym was started. So if you can give me the name of the gym, I've been calling it all morning, and when was it started, you could have a 1 week free membership to the gym, free of charge, courtesy of my guests. The numbers, 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259. And don't act like you all don't need the gym, you know. Look at yourself. Let me tell you what I want you to do. Stand up right now, wherever you are. Wherever you are, stand up. Walk to the nearest mirror. Go on, I'll give you 5 seconds. Mm-hmm. 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 Hold your two hands up like the medical man. You know how the medical man holds his hand up? So that should be parallel with the deck or parallel with whatever the floor is. Stand in front of the mirror. Don't move. Shake your hands. If they wobble in, you need to go to the gym. Don't move yet. Don't move yet. Don't move yet. Don't move yet. Take your hands. Bend them in the shape of a 90-degree triangle. Or is that a 90? A 60-degree triangle. Put your index finger right above that belt line. Put your thumb right below your rib. Squeeze. If what you just grabbed is in excess of an inch and a half, you need to go to the gym. This is very easy to figure out. All right? Let's do the last one. We got one more for you. Stand in front of the mirror. Put your 2 foot together. Put your hands completely at your side. Put your chin on your chest. If you can't see your belt, you need to go to the gym. All right? And I know, ham and turkey tasted good. But since you like to eat ham and turkey, enjoy the gym. All right? Let's take the phone call. Good morning, caller. You're on. Call it up.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, where is it, Leyvon?
Hi, good.
Listen, Raw Fitness.
Mm-hmm.
I can say what you say. I'm mm-hmm. quoting you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm quoting him.
Mm-hmm.
In the pandemic.
That's exactly when it is, and that's exactly what the name of the gym is. Hold the line. My producer will get your name and your number, and we will get you your 1 free week. All right? Hold the line. 323-623-2325-4316-325-4259. I feel like we must even give out one more these days. Yeah. So he say he can give me 3. We can give out 4, because I feel like we have some people that are going to. What exactly did he do before he started Raw Fitness? I said he did something in particular before he started Raw Fitness. If you can tell me what that is, we'll give you a free week at Raw, free of charge. 323-623-2325-4316-325-4259. You can call me. Let's take the call, Kermit. Good morning, caller. You're on. Not there. You can give me a call back. 323-623-2325-4316-325-4259. His name is Antonio Miller. He used to do something before he started Raw Fitness. He now does Raw Fitness. It started in the pandemic. But before that, he did something. If you can answer that question for me, you can have a free week. Let's try it. And don't act. I already tell you who all need the gym. 323-6232-325-4316-325-4259. You can't text me because you can't win. If you text, people could think I'm making it up for you all. I see you text, writer. That answer is actually correct. You could call me, though, because the phone lines are wide open. And get yourself a 1 week membership at Raw Fitness. So what is next on the... Do you have, like, social media sites and things like that people can find
you
on?
Yeah, definitely.
Great.
Definitely.
Give us some of that stuff. How do people find you? Where do they go to look for you? What are your contact numbers so that we could give those out?
Well, we have an Instagram page, Raw Fit. And mm-hmm. we also have a Facebook page under the same name, Raw Fitness.
Mm-hmm.
My contacts is 242-424-6809. That's 242-424-6809.
Mm-hmm. Do it one more time, because they always say that they didn't get it, so do it slowly this time.
424-6809.
Mm-hmm. And how do they find you on Facebook and, is that Facebook and Instagram?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, how do they find you on Facebook and Instagram?
Right under Raw Fit.
Raw Fit. And that's on Facebook and Instagram, and give them the number one more time because they require it most times. Go ahead.
424-6809.
you may think that I'm exaggerating with this phone number. You see those numbers right there? I say them 5 days a week for an hour each day, and people still tell me that they don't know the number because I say them too fast. I don't know. So, if you was listening, let's take this phone call. We asked a question, yeah? What is this phone call calling about? We have a question out there. What was the question? What question. Did he do before? What did he do before he started Raw Fit? Caller, you're on. Caller, you there? Caller, you there? I see the phone line, but I don't see it. Caller, you there? Okay.
Hello?
Hey, how you doing? You live?
Hi, I'm good.
Mm-hmm. What did he do before he started Raw Fit?
He worked in the hotel industry.
He worked in the hotel industry. Yeah, absolutely.
Timeshare, to be exact.
Pardon?
Timeshare, to be exact.
See, this is happening when they know you personally.
Yeah, I was listening.
All right. Okay, hold the line. Hold the line. We'll get you your free 1 week membership. All right.
Thank you.
All right. I don't know. Let's give out one more. Let's give out one more. That was three. Let's give out because I like even numbers.
We got one more.
Everybody that know me know I like even numbers. I drink even number beers. I'm an even number kind of guy, right? If you could tell me the number to get in contact with Raw Fit, you want to see how serious this is? How many times was you gave it? 6 times, right? If you could give me the number for Raw Fit.
Come on, that's easy.
If you could, I want to give it to them. I want to give it to them. If you could give me the number for Raw Fit, you could have yourself 1 week at the Raw Fit gym. These people, I do this every week. I've been saying 323-6232. 325-4316 and 325-4259. You notice I didn't have to look at the paper.
Yeah.
I say it, that's how many times I say it, right? They still say, you keep saying the number so fast. I never could get it. So let's see if they could get the number for Raw Fit, because then maybe I'll just let you come here and call the number.
That's all.
All right? Caller, you're on. Caller, you're
there? Hello?
Hi.
What is this?
424-6809.
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
What my number is?
1-325-4259.
You know, well, give me the next one.
I don't know the next one.
I don't know the next one. All right, Carla, no problem. Hold the line. My producer will take your name and your number, all right?
All right.
Okay. So, Tonio, you have been doing this now since the pandemic. What exactly are the next few steps that you see going on with Raw Fit? I mean, I know a lot of people are into outdoor workouts, etc. A lot of people are into plyometric workouts and just using body mass workout mechanisms, etc. What exactly, if anything, do you have in your mind with regards to expansion of Raw?
So the goal of Raw really is to be able to give the same experience that you will have at a big gym,
mm-hmm.
but just in a more condensed way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for example, when I looked around and I saw how the other, let's say, home gyms look, they lack a lot of the fundamental equipment
mm-hmm.
that Raw has.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as simple as a Smith machine, where you can do your bench press or your squats, we have that. So mm-hmm. you can work out your leg, pretty much your whole upper body with cable flies and everything in one machine. So we have that. We have a treadmill. So if you need to do, you get your cardio in, whether it be solid state cardio or your HIIT cardio, we have mm-hmm. that there as well.
Mm-hmm.
We also have an elliptical. Mm-hmm. So if you like the fact of all muscle group working the same time, trying to get those calorie count up, that's a nice way to do it,
mm-hmm.
all right? And of course, we have the dumbbell sets, okay? We also have what I call the powerhouse. That's called the powerhouse because that's what the big guys normally mm-hmm. use. You have up to 200, almost 300 pounds of weight that you can use doing, whether that's flies, whether that's lateral pull down, whether that's quad extensions, whether that's chest or shoulder workout in this one tower. Then we have cables. So one of the good things about Raw is that we found ways that you can use cable to pretty much maximize or have the whole body workout as
mm-hmm.
well.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have space to do your ab workout. We have some areas to do your lunges. We have some areas to do your steps. So we pretty much, I am trying to, the goal of Raw, or let's say where I see Raw going, is pretty much having all the benefit of a Max 360 per se
mm-hmm.
or a Better Bodies right there, just in a condensed form
mm-hmm.
where you don't have to go anywhere. Because think of it, Mr. Miller, the reason why the big gym have, let's say, 6 or 7 of the same machines is because they have such a big group.
Right.
You know, they only had one
leg press machine. So you're saying that you have diversity even if you don't have quantity. So you don't need 12 leg press machines.
No,
you have a leg press machine, which is something you wouldn't normally have at a small gym.
Yes.
You have a pec deck, which is you don't need 12 of them because you don't intend to ever have that many people there.
No.
You want it to be a personalized, homely experience, kind of like where everybody's like brother and sister, and we come here and we have a great time and we look good together.
And not only that, when you come there, you know that I came here to do something.
Right.
And kid you not, having that environment conducive to what you want to do mm-hmm. is key, because oftentimes you go to a gym
and you get lost. Yeah.
Because what happens is you get swallowed up.
Yeah.
You know, you're there like you're that one drop of water in this whole ocean, right?
Right.
And you get swallowed up because there's just so much other things going on. Like you said, the big guy there distracting you because
he eating a 25-pound plate. He comes in the gym. I let me tell you, those are the ones that really get me. He comes in the gym, he just eat a 25-pound plate when he walk in, so you know he's serious. Then he grabs every piece of weight in the room, every 45-pound he could find.
And
just stack it on a rod.
Whereas when you there with your 10 pounds and you feel like, well, I don't even qualify to be in the same space with him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's, it shouldn't be that way. It shouldn't be that way. Your experience with with working out should be a good experience.
Yeah, so it's like a people-to-people gym experience.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It should be an awesome experience. That. You know what I mean?
Some people obviously want to talk to you. Let's take this phone call. Good morning, Collie. You're on. Collie, there? Collie, you're on.
Hey, Mr. Miller, what's up, bro?
Hey, what's going on, dude?
Hey, good morning, and good morning to Mr. I call it Mr. Fitness.
Mm-hmm.
I hear you, Mr. Miller. Someone asked me this morning to ask you, and they asked me to ask Vaughn this question. Why you think some people want us to go back into, they call it mental slavery in some cases, and physical slavery in some cases. Why do you think they want us, they want the government to lock down or curfew us? They wanted me to ask you and Vaughn that question. And they wanted to hear your answer. You have a good day, my
brother. No problem, Lubit. Well, I tell you what, I'm planning to go back inside. So if they plan to lock me back inside, my friends down there, who I'm sure are capable of shooting, have to prove to me how good they is at shooting. Let's take another phone call. Good morning, Carly. You're on. I always opposed having fundamental freedoms fondled. And I don't anticipate that I'm going to go back down that road willfully or willingly. And so, no problem. Put me in jail. Let's take the call. Good morning, Carly. You're on. I'm good.
Great, great, great. Listen, let me ask you something. Let me ask the instructor something.
Mm-hmm.
For a gentleman who is age of 66, how long should you hold your plank? Oh, is there any standard time?
Well, if you're starting out, plank is a really awesome core workout. If you're just starting out, and if you can hold your plank, let's say, just for starting now, let's say between a minute to a minute and a half, that's
mm-hmm.
that's a good hold. Now,
a minute and a half is plenty.
I know exactly.
A minute and a half is plenty.
But you gotta remember now, you put your watch underneath you, and after that first 30 to 40 seconds, you should feel some burn.
Yeah,
the engagement of the core doesn't happen until the burn starts. In other words, there's some workout, you know, I work with a client of mine, and when it burns, he starts to count. He's mm-hmm. like, okay, I get 10 reps for you. But he only starts to count after the burn. So mm-hmm. core is kind of like that.
Because like I said, I'm 66, and I do like four different versions of planks, and I hold each one, the straight arm plank,
mm-hmm.
the forearm plank,
uh-huh.
the side plank,
uh-huh.
right and left, and offer medicine ball.
That's 2 minutes. That side plank don't play.
And I do them for 2 minutes at age 66.
That's awesome. I kid you not. Well, you know the answer to this question before you even ask that question. You know, you're trying to set me up. But man, definitely 2 minutes, especially that side plank. And
yeah.
do you after you do one left, do you go straight into the right?
Or straight in. I go straight from 2 minutes to the next one
Yeah, no, that's nice.
I want to also make sure that you're very cautious to protect your. I hope you're wearing a support belt. No, because planking.
I don't have no issue with my back or anything like that.
Right. Yeah, I wouldn't recommend having a support belt just for plank. You want to engage your core.
No, yes. I get you, but I there are a lot of people that try to, you know, there are people who have their brain is a whole lot more athletic than their
uh-huh.
body is.
Uh-huh.
And if you are one of those persons, you have to, you know, take the necessary, don't break out in the morning and decide you're going to side plank for 2 minutes. Your belly is probably going to hang over the side and drag your spine in the wrong direction.
And then sometimes I do it off my my stability board. Hold it for 2 minutes.
Right. But you're talking about somebody, if I know this voice correctly, this is somebody that I think walks about 8 or 9 miles a week or something to that effect.
Yeah, this does.
Right. So
yeah,
I mean,
man, 2 minutes. Come on, man. Yeah. I told you, you're trying to set me up. You know the answer to this already, man.
Yeah.
You know that is a. I must tell you, that is an awesome thing to do. Especially if have you ever done plank and shoulder touch with a straight arm, where you have your straight arm and then you alternate touching each shoulder.
No, I guess I was looking at the plank this morning and I saw that I can incorporate that.
Yeah, man. Just throw it in there. You realize that you use the minor muscle groups because you have to stabilize yourself now while doing the plank.
Yes.
And also get that core engaged as well. Yeah, but
yes.
but what's your name, sir?
My name is Douglas Storr.
Yeah, it's Doug. Okay.
And let me just say, because when I look, one time I went and looked, and they say, oh, at age 60 or 50, you're only supposed to hold it for 45 seconds. I say, I can defy that order.
Yeah, good job.
But
good
that's kind of who he is. Appreciate you, Doug. That's kind of who he is. He's one of those, you know, people that pushes the envelope. One of those people who refuses to let time catch up with them.
Yeah.
So they continue to wear tennis and they continue to try it out runtime.
Yeah.
That's just what happened.
Yeah.
Right? Text right here says, great show as usual. Tell your guests, this is the Bahamas. In the Bahamas, if we feel the burn, first thing cross our mind is we have to stop. Yeah. So, well, you know, most times, here's what I tell people. If you feel bad, you probably look bad. The better working out makes you feel, the better your body looks. What do I mean? If every time you work it off, when you work out, you feel like, oh my God, stand a stretcher, I'm dying. Chances are you look terrible, right? Because the more you enjoy workout, like the more you get a workout and say, boy, I really had a good back yesterday, or man, I really, the more you begin to kind of cherish that burning sensation or that tenderness,
mm-hmm.
You begin to see the transformation in your body. And so I've always used the slogan in the gym, if you feel bad, keep waking because you look bad. Let's keep going, right? And, you know, people say, oh, you're so hard in the gym or you're so hard when you're training. And, you know, it's because this isn't supposed to. The sweetness is when you was eating the cake. You eat the cake, right? You love that. You love cake.
That's the two sides of the coin.
You love cake, right? Come put some of these in here and love these as well. And that's kind of how you know, I've always tried to push people through workouts. But someone has messaged and said, can he say the number again, please? Because I didn't get it, just like I told you. So give them the number one more time before we get out of here.
Right before that, Levan, you know, it's funny because one of the I guess, scariest things people don't like about workout
mm-hmm.
is that the feeling after the workout.
Mm-hmm.
That's when the lactic acid is all built up in the muscles, you know, and in the joints. And then you feel like, okay, I'm feeling sore pain now. Just a little tip. There's a way to minimize that soreness you would feel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a hot shower. Get into some water.
Mm-hmm.
A hot shower. Salt water works great, by the way, to release some of the lactic acid that's inside your muscle.
Mm-hmm.
But also, I mean, even if you would like, there's BC branch amino chain
mm-hmm.
Where you can get your BCAAs,
mm-hmm.
and that help with that's an after workout. Supplement that actually help with feeling that soreness.
Yeah, yeah.
But to say this, that is, you want to work towards that soreness because what it does is it shows that, okay, I've done some work.
Correct.
That's the result of it.
Well, tell people how to give them the number one more time because we got to get it here. I'm flat out of time. So give them your number.
It's 424-6809.
Mm-hmm. His number is 424-6809. 09. We're fresh out of time. Tony Miller, thank you so much for coming. I don't hear
my
music yet, but I should be getting out of here. I'm Leyvon Miller. It's Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. They're your station for fresh news and smart talk. So don't move the news. It happens now.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
One day.
Yeah, I can
when the war is won, we will be sure.